Kamalam new Portia, Sbungusam new Modise, a former player Banyana Banyana, Yazum Shaima Koli, a top goal scorer, Mzansi and I say Africa. There's 5 things you don't know about me, but you're gonna find out about it. My sexuality, I'm very gay. It's not even funny. I never hide it from the first start. And I want to advise other parents out there. You know, there are a lot of kids who are like me. And most of them, I normally talk to them over my Facebook, over my social media. They're complaining about the parents that they don't understand. They'll call them about satanism. Antabatal, meaning singing is satanism. I became a Portia Modise just because of the person that I am. And just because I had good parents, I have a supporter and understanding which Azanga, Vuga, as Chuzela, then Pilling is Chuzela. No gum talong, you pay on. And even the communities, Mamelani, Bantabatala, Mamelan, Bantanabasaka, Abusis, Bantabu put way to that they think Nati, the Mpilasi Pillar, it's not important or Iko real. It's so real. It's not even funny. Nati, one day we'll have kids, one day we want to have families. But without your support and understanding where we're coming from, where we're going, we belonging to the community, we want you to support us. And also LGBTI, probably it's your part, you know, to make sure. The communities understand about us. It's your part, it's your role to make sure which communities and people is Pira Nabu in our community understand that there are people like us and who are living with them in the society. So big. Your support is very important, especially when Nabantu and Abafana no push. It's very difficult when the world is against you and the Gunyanantos will change our life. We can't change it. Mina ngeke ngichange, but with the support that I normally get, Kaslami, KNZ, YCT, with the people that I live with, I grow up with, it's a big up, and I'm sure you're teaching other people, Guti. When you meet people about negative with the people like us, but change a little mentality, we're real. And the other thing, I always feel good about they misunderstand me, ngayo, especially when I talk about the money of women's football. I always talk and I fight for it out of my experience. I once being a player, I once presented my country. And the worst part was, while I was scoring those goals, scoring those 100 goals. But I don't want any other kids to experience what I've experienced. I invested so much, you know, now I'm thinking which one day, if I could put so much, put an effort, sacrifice myself, not having a childhood problem, one day football will pay me. I always dream one day which I could buy myself a house, I could have a family, I could take care of my family, I could take care of my mom. I have a disabled mom that I love so much. I'm saying things to her, you know, with her support, being a single parent, making sure which we raising us the way he did. I appreciate her mama. But God, okay, I'm just saying there are a lot of kids now who just want to appreciate her mama, but that are playing football, that they are not getting paid. Probably in my first salary, it was $50. So that is why today I always be a voice of women's football and try to fight for them and say they deserve better, because I know the situation and life is difficult after football, you're not getting paid. So Tabang, 102 goals. If I didn't get the sports star of the year, I'm sure I'm having Satalim Kukwin. But how many of us that is going to win the sports star of the year in order for them to improve probably their homes or to do something for their family that they support them so many years, you know, pushing, wearing that colorful jersey, a country, knowing which it doesn't give anything back. I'm just saying to our federation, you know, be reasonable for women's football and try to make things equal, because I do believe good. Well, it needs to be equal. The way you treat Bafana Bafana, you need to do it in the Nasamanto Mazanin. Because at the end of the day, we're looking to buy houses, we're looking to have a life, you know, in this choose the football. Why guys, they could have a life and a living after football, because they've been getting paid and playing for those teams that are getting paid. So with women, I feel we're just being exploited. And it's sad and it's very difficult to see. That is why I'm not going to keep quiet. We have a new generation that want to be like us. But let's create a good platform for them, which one day they could be a good example for others. Okay, I remember my first time going to play overseas. I went to play at Denmark, at Fortuna. It was not easy for the first time, you know, being overseas, signing a contract for 2 years. But my experience is it was never easy, but you are a foreigner. Sometimes you see other people entering in our country, then we call them a foreigner. I got to experience Nami one time, go by a foreigner, which is not nice. And I don't think that is the way we need to use, you know, when we see other people coming from other countries, we're saying they are foreigners, you know. They are visitors, we must say that. But yeah, my experience playing at Denmark, the 1 year, my first year, it was never easy, but they were not really accommodative. they were not speaking English. Normally, that is the popular, you know, language, you know, you can communicate with you when you travel all over the world, because it's central. But then in Denmark, they never make things easier for me. They didn't really speak English because they felt good. Why they have to bring someone that comes from the jungle? That was sad for me, because my coach, when he was looking at me, make a bang with the jungle in Slala Matiendi, my Kaluchi, Avogexen, Yau Simba, Andrew, the Lion King, Nali Pubil, Indro, Vianjula, you know, and Melan Jalabanguza, which made him funny doom, Wang Fun doom, Muslim. They're thinking in your Lalang apartment, they were asking me which made a bang ting, and it turned if I'm not comfortable in the house, they could buy me a tent, I could sleep outside. Like, they had a wrong conception here about Africa. But one thing that I liked after when we were hosting EU World Cup 2010, I felt that was an opportunity, you know, for them to come and see where I come from, my country. So it was too racist for me. But Ngoba, I felt good. As much as they think Ngoba made me stronger, and that is why I was able to stay and feeling good. I wanted to improve. I wanted to come back and help my country and being a better player and achieving a lot of things and winning more awards. So Denmark. But other than that, if I didn't want to pursue my career any further, wanting to leave a legacy, yo, Ngoba, it's not easy to be a foreigner. Okay, mina family ni yami siphuma ngiphuma efamily ni yaba umama mona abantwana abayi 3 mina ngiye last born ngiwestri. I had a brother, then I have a sister, masithi amantombazana nginobhuti 1, but I have other cousin abantwana bakasisi bakamamam nabo bayi 3, so I come from the family of 6. But yeah, ekhaya ngikhula kwabantu aba very generous, banenhliziyo enhle. Umama wami nogogo wami, they'll always find people nje that they'll always accommodate to bring in our house. You know, we'll end up living with the strangers, but we never look at them as strangers. We felt guti sibathatha njengamandla basekhaya, because ugogo wami always wanted to help people. Umama wami umuntu sharp, you know, umama umuntu sweet, umama muzifanela nama, I could say that. Uthanda abantu, you always want to help. And yeah, ukuthi nje angikhulanga nabazali, ngikhule estradeni, uyazi mani mawukhule kahle umntwana wasestradeni ngayingiploma emkhukhwini funa ukuzihrezela, you know, angina stress ngapha abazali bakwazi ukukubhayela ibhathi, you know. For me, I felt ukuthi ukuhlala ekhaya ukuba umntana kamama, ukuba umntana ka futhi ungakhulumi ngobaba, ngoba ubaba umuntu ogcina ke, I didn't even know my father. I started to know my father when I was 27, and when I knew my father, when I was introduced to my father, yazi man ufuna ukwenza izinto zomsebenzi, ufuna ukwenzela umsebenzi, then kwenzeka ukuthi 3 days before ngize ngihlangane naye ukuthi angenzele umsebenzi, then he passed away. But then another that I'm not qual. I had a grandmother that was disabled, and he tried to ask Kulise the best way he can, and he was saying, Joyce, siyabonga mama. You know, my mom always say, proud, I'm not proud, I'm khulumi ngaye most of the time, or ngiyashamed ngaye. Angikho ashamed ngaye mama, ngiyakuthanda ngoba if it was not you, you know, giving birth to me, I'm not sure ukuthi ngizoba this person that I am. And bheka, I salute you for effectively you trying so best to school the way school is in my corner, and being disabled and being a single parent. Bega, you have a strong woman. So and like I said, you know, when I started my conversation earlier on, I said there's one thing about me that probably others they don't know. I'm so gay, it's not even funny, and I don't apologize for that. And I feel good. There are a lot of kids who are bafana nami, I'm in a relationship. And I hate it so much when other people always say, baloko basikhweshina nge relationship yethu. And I find it weird, ngoba even straight people, they have their own relationship. Who questions you about your relationship? I just want to say, look at us, see us normal. And I mean, ngiyamthanda umuntu wami, I always have maybe 5 years naye, ngijola naye. I dated yena ngisese ela, I met her at Durban. Of course, we have a upside downs, you know. Sometimes, no, it's not like you in a good book. So not so cut. But okay, for the love of God, umuntu wami has been there for me and forgiving me with my problems that I come within the relationship. Like I'll always say again, our relationship is normal, like straight people. I don't wanna find you guys or seeing you guys or hearing you guys always asking us good. But kwenza kanjani mekwenza, hey, it's normal. Njenge yakho wena sikubuza ukuthi kwenza kanjani mekwenzakalani. So I'm saying to every child or fana no posh out there, don't be shy about yourself. Stand up and mamela, apologize for who you are. Find a way of trying to explain to your parents ukuthi who are you? And I'm just saying to the parents, iba nendlebe for abantwana benu, have a support ngoba ekugcineni umntana akho lo umlahlele ejangleni, you understand ubana ngeke understand ukuqala. My parents did that ukuthi bangunderstand ekuqala before bangilahlele ejangleni. Ngoba if they didn't support me and understand me first, ijangle nami izongihlula. But for them understand me first, ijangle was easy for me ukuthi ngibayenze ukuthi nabo ba understand. So I'm just saying ukuthi D, ngiyakuthandasana and be supportive the way you are, and then I'm gonna try to be supportive the way I am. Bye bye.